Now let us talk about controlling access using ACLs. ACLs stands for access control lists and it gives final level access control over files. Without ACLs, permissions are controlled at owner, group and other levels only. So here I am connecting to the gateway node of the cluster which we have set up on the Google Cloud platform. As we proceed with respect to HDFS commands, I have asked you to create users called demo and Cloudera on top of ITVarsity. I have used ITVarsity itself to log in onto this gateway node. I can see the properties with respect to this user. He belonged to groups such as ITVarsity, admin, video, and Google sudoers. But when it comes to other users, which I have asked to create, such as Cloudera and demo, they are just regular users and they belong to only their respective groups. Make sure you have created all these users and also user spaces for all these three users. So if you actually say Hadoop fs-ls/user, there should be subdirectories called Cloudera as well as demo here. And you can see that for demo, the owner is demo, and for Cloudera, the owner is Cloudera itself. Now we'll be using all these three to actually explore ACLs. However, before getting into the ACLs, first we need to enable ACLs at the cluster level. And the way you can do it is by going to Cloudera Manager. You can click on this HDFS, then configuration, and then you can search for ACLs. And you have to click on this to enable ACL on our cluster. Once you save changes, you have to apply those changes by clicking on this icon. You have to restart the services. If you already set up many other services than HDFS, this action will actually take care of restarting all the services that are dependent on HDFS. However, in our cluster, we only have Zookeeper and HDFS now, and Zookeeper is not dependent on HDFS, and hence only HDFS will be restarted. But if you have other things, and if it is a live cluster, you have to be careful when you are trying to set these things up, because it will end up restarting all the services which are dependent on HDFS, including HDFS itself, and it can cause downtime for some of the applications that might be running at that time. So you need to get the 0R, and you should be able to make these changes when no user traffic is coming to the cluster. So I clicked on restart now. It will take a bit of time depending upon the number of services you have on the cluster, and then you should be able to finish and then complete the restart process. Now the restart process is done. You just have to click on finish. This icon will go off because we already restarted. It is just temporary. Make sure there are no icons with respect to restarting any of the services before you proceed further. As of now, we have enabled ACLs on the cluster, and also we have all the three users, ITVarsity, Cloudera, as well as demo, with user space in HDFS, which can be used to demonstrate some of the use cases with respect to ACLs.